أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
The status of the Quraysh was shaken. The outstanding victory of Muslims in Badr seriously weakened the reputation of Quraysh in Arabia. So they wanted to regain their reputation. The Quraysh prepared an army of 3,000 well-equipped men under the leadership of Abu Sufyan and marched towards Medina. Scouts of Medina discovered this plot of the Mushrikun of Makkah and informed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about it. After being informed, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gathered the Muslims and the Jews in Masjid al-Nabvi and consulted the situation with them. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's opinion was to defend inside the city, but the youths among the Muslims were very enthusiastic and wanted to stop the invasion before reaching Medina. The Jews of Medina did not want to participate to defend Medina, and the Muslims were able to gather only about 1,000 men to defend Medina. The Muslim men set out towards the mountain of Uhud, while the women and children in Medina remained vigilant on the rooftops with stones in case when Muslims were unable to stop them from entering Medina. On the way towards the Uhud, 300 of Munafiqun betrayed the Muslim army and returned back to Medina, and the Muslim number decreased to 700. The Muslim camp in Uhud before the Quraysh, and the Muslims had an advantage that they were protected by three sides with the help of Uhud ranges, and the two sides were open from which the Quraysh could attack. There was a hill between both sides, and Prophet ﷺ posted 50 archers under the command of Abdullah bin Jubayr to guard one of the paths and to protect the Muslim from behind. The Prophet ﷺ also commanded them to not to leave their position under any circumstances until Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered them to do so. The Quraysh army also reached and camped at Uhud. The leader was Abu Sufyan, the right wing was commanded by Khalid bin Walid, and the left wing was commanded by Ikrimah. The Meccan army had 3,000 well-equipped men, 200 cavalry and 300 camels, while Muslim had 700 men, 4 cavalries and 50 archers. Then the battle took place. The Muslim fought bravely and they killed and wounded many warriors of Quraysh with the help of Allah, and the Quraysh started to desert the battlefield, leaving behind a great deal of booty. The Muslims, seeing the victory certain, left their positions and greedily fell upon the booty. Some archers also said that, "Let's go, we won," but Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anha didn't allow them as it was commanded by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But they disobeyed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and 40 archers left their positions, leaving 10 archers behind who stayed at their position. Khalid bin Walid saw this rumor and attacked the Muslims near the hill. The Muslims were in greed and spread it, so were unable to stop the attack from behind. Then Khalid bin Walid marched towards the camp of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they shot arrows on group who had surrounded Prophet, peace be upon him. Then the Muslims also retreated the battlefield and protected Prophet, peace be upon him. Prophet, peace be upon him, also suffered wounds on his face and lost a tooth. Ash also had a great loss, which is why they retreated and didn't finish it off, as the Quraysh had a great loss. But the Quraysh retreated and didn't finish it off, as they got a rumor that an army was approaching from Medina to help the Muslims. Indeed, it was help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslims had a great loss in this battle. 70 Muslims were martyred. Prophet, peace be upon him, uncle Hazrat Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anha was also martyred in this battle. Hazrat Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha got 70 wounds for protecting Prophet peace be upon him. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi wa sallam later on used to say about him that Talha is a walking shaheed. The Battle of Uhud had a great moral lessons. It taught Muslims to be united and to be disciplined. It also taught Muslims to never prefer this world over the hereafter. It also taught Muslims that disobedience to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam can only result failure. And after this battle, Muslims became more obedient to Islam and Prophet peace be upon him.